Jaeger, something like a monster festers under a number of layers. All the king's horses and all the king's men and investigators couldn't put the case together, couldn't neutralize the danger. They put good in the as he killed her, but not before he raped her. Leslie Shelley and her neighbor, April Broda, Deborah Taylor. Robin disappeared to be found dead by joggers 1 week later. Don't put all your eggs in one container. Michael was a roadside strangler. Alice Meeker's death day, tomorrow, 144 years ago, tomorrow she was murdered by her babysitter aunt. Poor little Alice was a household slave, ever since her Andy and her so-called caretaker, meaner than an alligator with a son who will bitter every word out of fear of her anger, beat Alice with a broomstick every day. Predicted by the neighbors when they finally do convey their concern was too little and a little too late. Murdered and Maple Day in April 1880. They wake her with a bag over her head. They call her an ungrateful complainer. Alice knew the perpetrators. This was her family, not some strangers. She must have known she was in danger. She must have wondered why they hate her. Forced to drink the sugar water with a bitter strychnine flavor. Died in pain when the poison took effect 20 minutes later. But they forgive him, make sure to get the story straight. For him, a letter of stupidity betrayed her. The prisoner was that capacity was spectators. Spring was in the air, the dead they hate her. Oh. I got drunk last night. I drank 6 Nanny Daddies, and then I took out the scissors and started cutting my hair. And fucking, I woke up the next morning. This morning I woke up, went next door to take a shit, and I looked in the mirror and fucking, I had a mullet. I don't know if it was like my subconscious, like white trash mullet, Nanny Daddy issues. I don't know what happened, but I quickly corrected the problem.
Nice,
thanks.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't.
That looks like what you described.
Oh, I'm going to play another one just for that. Let's see. All right, I guess I'm just going to play part of it. Real quick, because Iggy Pop's birthday. Wait. Okay, I'm going to play a terrible, fucked up song real quick because Iggy Pop and Robert Plant were born on the same day. They both turned 77 yesterday. Robert Plant was a notorious pedophile. This one's in A minor. This whack-ass Robert Black, a British piece of human trash. Swimming pool attendant, like watching little girls play in splash. After hours, he'd swim laps with a broomstick clutched in his ass. It's not that he had no class. These are just arbitrary facts. It had more to do with the murders and the sexual attacks. They pulled a man over and looked back. They found a girl bound and gagged. Her body was already in the bag. Take her like a she was glad. Sailing back with mom and dad, but now most of her dreams are bad. Alright, this is a sing-along for Iggy Pop's birthday. Even if you've never heard this song before, even if you hate Iggy Pop, you gotta sing along with it. And the stars in the sky, I like them better than you. The stars in the sky, they tell me what to do. I don't care about your city or your fat income. Everybody, starry night, starry, starry, starry night, starry night, starry, starry, starry night, starry night, starry, starry, starry night, starry night, it makes me feel alright. And in the clubhouse, I heard a lot of tough talking. It all looks pretty lovely. Something here is absolutely wrong. Ugly, ugly, under the starry night. this is not your lighter, Queen.
Got another lighter right here.
What? I'm a queen. I didn't know.
Get over here, Queen.
I'll let you throw a fire.
Why? What are you gonna do? Light a firecracker on your face?
I am the hero of the dragon.
Smelling all of us. Doesn't matter who you are. When we were kids, lighting off secret firecrackers, that's that smell. Take you right back to your childhood. That's what this show is all about, ladies and gentlemen. Things are going well. No furniture was broken. No harm has come to anybody yet. It's a long night, but we're gonna do this. Ladies and gentlemen, before we introduce our new guests, please welcome to the stage a few moments of perhaps comedy, perhaps psychology, perhaps just somebody talking to you. You'll never know. The one, the only, Elmar! Give him a round of applause. You're in for it.
I knew him when he was sober!
Top of the ladies, gentlemen, give him a round of applause. MC extraordinaire! Yes!
It's going well.
Okay,
it's going well.
I know you're wondering about the accent. You're thinking Alabama? Thank you. No, it's New York. And I had a different, you know, childhood. I went to school, public school.
Louder.
In New York.
Hold it closer.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, so I made a joke about an accent and you didn't even hear it?
No, we heard the accent. That's not what he was saying.
Oh, look at that. That's my manager, people. That's my manager. So, one of my things in school in New York is a little weird and different from here, okay? I had a project as an 8-year-old, okay? And we did things different. We didn't have to present like what our dads did. We had to present what our moms did. We were different. And so...
Because your moms did everything.
My mom did everything. Except want to be known. So I went home with the teacher's project. And I said, Mom, I have a project at school. And the teacher gave me some questions for you. And one of them was, how old are you? Just to get to know you. And my mom said, oh, son. That's a question you never ask a lady, how old she is. I'm like, okay, I went from an A to a B all of a sudden. Okay, Mom, how about this question? How much do you weigh?
Oh!
Yep, thank you. My mom said, no, you never ask anyone, male or female, how much they weigh. All right, okay, Mom, here's a question that's specific to you that you can answer. Why did Dad leave us? And she goes, son?
Oh, shit!
Son, yeah, New York. Son, when you get older, I'll have that conversation with you. Dejected, I went to bed and worried about that grade. I was going to get a C or a D. Next morning, I go for breakfast, and I see my mom's ID, driver's license. And I go, oh, here's all the answers. I say, Mom, you're 33 years old. He goes, how do you know? And not only that, you weigh 135 pounds. Whoa. I says, whoa. And I know Dad left us because you got an F in sex. So, here we do things different. So here I am in Florida. I've been here 20 years, okay? And I've been here 20 years, and I have different experiences, okay? Especially now, with all the things in the news, I'll make a confession. I'm a deeply religious person. Hold your booze, okay? It's not easy. It's not easy being deeply religious, especially now. I'm afraid of wearing red.
I got rid of all my red because everybody I know gets associated with that type of thing. And I'm trying to get along with people and get to know them. Because I'm thinking that, you know what, it would be a better world if different religions spoke to each other. We're talking, if Buddhists spoke to Hindus, it would be a better world. If Jews would speak to Muslims, it would be a better world. If Christians spoke to, I don't know, Democrats, it would be a better world. Find out now.
In what language?
Thank you. Thank you, guys. I only have a couple of minutes left. And like Tom said, sometimes I'll do jokes, maybe I'll tell a story. I have a weird life, okay? And things just happen to me. For example, I had a kid in my neighborhood who's walking around throwing rocks everywhere. And I told him, hey, be careful with that. You know, you might hit somebody, you might break my window, okay? I don't feel safe when you're throwing rocks around just for the fun of it. So he told me what? He told me to fuck off, okay? Oh, by the way, a deeply religious person saying fuck off? Wait. A deeply religious person drinking? Whoa. A deeply religious person hanging out with beautiful people? Gay, lesbian, anything? Yeah. It's funny because everybody tells us not to tell them what to do, and then they tell me what to do. What? You shouldn't be doing that. So this kid, he continues to do that. One day, a rock came through my window. A rock just shot through my window. Well, I got mad and scared. I have a right to defend my home. So I went out, found that kid's home, tied his mom, dad, and him and his little sister up. I set fire to their furniture and let them sit there while I burnt their house down. And at the end of it, the police came and said, why'd you do it? And I said, because I have a right to defend myself. The cop said, wasn't that an overreaction? And of course, I looked at him and I said, since I got a right to defend myself, if I'm wrong, then some people that are doing that right now are just as fucking wrong. Thank you. Thank you. Now look, I'm not talking about Gaza and Israel in the sense of right to defend themselves and all that. I'm a simple person, okay? All I'm saying, if they can fucking overreact, so can I. People got mad at that joke. They want to cancel me, saying I'm anti-Semitic. Like,
but you're Jewish.
First of all, I'm Jewish. Second of all, that family wasn't Jewish because I'm in Florida. They were black.
Fuck you, man.
It's all good until I go personal. So, some people don't like that joke, and I just turn around and tell them, I'm sorry. And they say, you don't mean it.
This isn't Sanford.
And when they say you don't mean it, I say, oh, so you do understand I can say shit I don't mean.
Say more.
There you go. Thank you. Guys, that was my 5 minutes or 2 minutes. Thank you for being such a great audience. Top level people.
Elmore, give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Provocative dialogue, provocative dialogue. You're at the tabernacle, who knows what you're going to do. Now we're going to get into it. Folks, brand new to the tabernacle, we are very excited to introduce Wandana. By the way, as Wandana is getting set up to go,